Welcome back to Montana This Morning. The time is 6:46, and no, you don't have to adjust your TV sets. That's actually what it looks like outside right now. Ugh, snow. Fog in some areas, snow in others. There you have it. Just one of those days. I wish I could say it's Friday, but it's not. We still have one day until the week is up. There's a live look outside. Let's go ahead and get started with the news. President Trump travels to Ohio today amid another shakeup in his administration. The president announced on Twitter Wednesday he's replacing Veterans Affairs Secretary David Shulkin with White House physician Ronnie Jackson. Jackson delivered the results of Trump's first presidential physical exam in January. And closer to home, more than 2 years after a deadly shooting in downtown Billings, we now know prosecutors have decided not to file murder charges because they believe the shooter would be found not guilty. That's because the apparent victim in the case was the aggressor. In a memo to the Billings Police Department dated October of 2017, Yellowstone County prosecutors say Nicholas Franzen shot and killed 42-year-old Sean Allred. A fight between the two apparently began because Franzen did not pay for some cocaine. The memo states Allred threatened to come over and, quote, make it right. Later that night, Allred entered Franzen's home on North 24th Street without permission. Franzen claims Allred cornered him and pulled out a gun before Franzen shot him about 20 times. Prosecutors believe a jury could reasonably find Franzen acted in self-defense. A district court judge in Helena says author John Krakauer will get access to university documents concerning the high-profile rape case on the University of Montana campus 5 years ago. However, Krakauer will receive a redacted version to protect students involved in the investigation. Krakauer has fought several years to access the full records. He maintains there are still unanswered questions about how UM leadership handled the investigation and eventual expulsion that preceded the rape trial and acquittal of UM quarterback Jordan Johnson. The judge ruled the document should be released to Krakauer by May 23rd. However, it's expected the state could appeal the ruling, sending it back to the Montana Supreme Court. In state news, the Bullock administration is now taking action to avoid further cuts in several human service programs. Governor Steve Bullock has told state lawmakers he may need an additional $23 million in spending authority this year. The governor made the request earlier this month for what's known as supplemental funding. That means he'll transfer the money from next budget year to this year to avoid further cuts now, and then ask the legislature to give retroactive approval in 2019. The money will pay for higher Medicaid caseloads, nurses and psychiatrists at the state hospital in Warm Springs, and more workers to investigate child abuse and neglect. The request also includes money to pay for cost overruns at the Office of the Public Defender.
The governor has no appetite for additional cuts at the Department of Public Health and Human Services. We just can't afford it, nor can Montanans. We're not asking for program expansions. We're not asking for service expansions. We're just asking for fund the programs that exist now.
State lawmakers have scheduled a conference call in May to discuss the proposal. Back here in Billings, as plans for the One Big Sky Center evolve, the focus is now on funding. During a meeting Wednesday, project coordinators discussed raising $675,000. Big Sky Economic Development would serve as the contracting agent with Hammis Company. Strategy partners include the Billings Chamber, Visit Billings, Downtown Billings, and the city. Some of the $675,000 still needs to be raised, and the City Council will soon vote on whether or not to contribute $100,000. The Hammis Company would put $1.2 million toward the project. It's now determining how to redevelop downtown instead of just one tower at the One Big Sky Center.
It's much broader than that, just that one tower concept that was originally floated, and I think that's smart. From an economic development standpoint, you don't want to say, let's do this one thing. You want to say, let's look at what are the most strategic things that we can do. Those are planning areas that have been developed, and we'll look at what are the key projects in those areas.
Steve Arbuskow is talking about an area downtown around the hospitals and near MSUB. He will work on an agreement for the partners, a finance and funding plan, and a planning agreement with Hammis. He hopes to get this done in the next 30 days and get the process started in May. Elsewhere this winter, the snow and brutal cold spelled disaster for fish ponds in south central Montana. One of the most notable areas was at Riverfront Park in Billings. Montana FWP biologists report a large fish kill at at the park this week, and they expect to find even more as the ice melts. The cold didn't directly kill the 10 different fish species, but it did cause a trickle-down effect. The ice and snow killed the aquatic plants, and as the plants decomposed, the bacteria consumed most of the oxygen in the water, literally suffocating the fish. Fish, Wildlife, and Parks says this story isn't all bad. The fish who do survive will have less competition for the new plant growth, which means they will grow bigger. Across northwest Montana, bears are playing hide-and-seek with hikers and biologists. Sightings of black bears and grizzlies have always been an iconic symbol of winter's end. And just like us, after a good sleep, bears get hungry. Fish, Wildlife, and Parks says radio collars show more and more bears hunting for food. But that hunger draws them into residential areas and forces specialists to intervene. Hikers are urged to be bear aware, especially because bears will be far more aggressive while feeding. Well, Billings may be the biggest, but Bozeman is growing twice as fast, outpacing the entire state. The annual U.S. Census shows since 2010, Gallatin County grew by 20% to almost 108,000 people. Yellowstone County holds a solid number, one spot at 158,000, increasing by 11,000. Missoula County comes in second at 117,000. Gallatin County moved past Flathead to take the number three spot, and Flathead County is fourth. Cascade County, where the Great Falls population has remained flat, is in fifth. The state of Montana grew by more than 6% since 2010. The population is now at 1,050,000 people. And speaking of Montana's population, a new report identifies the safest cities in the state, and Laurel makes the top three. SafeWise reviewed the 2016 FBI crime report statistics and population data. It shows Laurel has 1.43 violent crimes per 1,000 residents, and 93% of crime falls under property crime. Police still battle drugs within the community, and the Laurel police chief says there's still a need for more officers.
I think my guys do a marvelous. I wrote them a note saying, Captain wrote them a note, I wrote them a note. They do really good work, and those guys solve a lot of crimes, and they're out there. When I started in 1983, we had 8 officers. 35 years later, we're only at 13. So the people that understand, the mayor or the council, I understand we need more people. It's all about funding.
The town is in the early stages of discussing a possible public safety mill levy. Residents voted down the last attempt in 2014. Dillon and Columbia Falls are the two other safest cities across Montana, and Billings, by the way, did not make the list. Now we go to the Montana Rescue Mission, where a few more ingredients are needed to make Sunday's Easter dinner just right. The mission is asking for donations of butter and pie, which can be dropped off at the men's shelter on Minnesota Avenue. The Montana Rescue Mission expects to feed around 400 people this year. Anyone who would like a meal delivered should sign up by Friday afternoon. The annual Easter meal takes place after the noon church service. Wrapping up our news on this Thursday, some of the best and brightest area teachers and principals were honored for their work in education. Take a look at this year's Golden Apple Award winners: Dolly John, Diane Brown, Nicole Bogonovich, Joe Halligan, Angie Gray, Sandra Kreider, and Rob Waite. The Billings Education Association also honored senior high science teacher and frequent Montana This Morning guest Craig Beals as Teacher of the Year. Karen Moses, by the way, was named Friend of Education. A big congratulations goes out to all of them.